Hey everybody, welcome to an episode of Rotors Magazine. My name is Kenny McKee, and today we're talking about five things every new car enthusiast needs to know before jumping in the car scene. Now this is based on my own personal experience as well as things that I've seen, and I've made some of these mistakes, and I want to help the community not do that in the future. So I have five things that I want to go over, and the first one we're going to get right off the bat is don't ask stupid questions. Now, before you flip this video off and say I'm being elitist or whatever you want to say, that's not what I'm doing at all. So when I say don't ask stupid questions, I understand that everybody starts somewhere. I understand that not everyone knows everything at the beginning or whatever. Like that's what I'm addressing. I'm saying that if you want to learn something, you need to put forth an effort before you ask a question. Now, to iterate my point, cars have been around for a very long time. Car culture has been around for a very long time. And pretty much every car that you're trying to jump into has forums or Facebook groups that have every bit of information you could possibly need. So there's no reason why you shouldn't be able to hop on Google and type in your issue and figure it out from there. Now, for instance, a stupid question would be, how do I turbocharge my D-Series Honda? How do I turbocharge a car? What should I look for when trying to buy a car? Things like that. Those are very basic questions that can be found pretty much in a 5-second Google search. If I can find an answer to a question in a 5-second Google search and you come to me and ask a question, I'm just going to assume you didn't do any sort of research, put forth any sort of effort. So why would I give you every bit of information that I've accumulated over time to someone who hasn't put forth the effort to find it? And I know that rings true for a lot of different people, and a lot of people won't tell you this, but that's how it is. If you look like you haven't put forth an effort, people are less privy to give you information. So when you're looking for more information, trying to learn about cars, look it up first. Use Google first. Use Facebook groups. Peruse, creep, stalk, whatever you got to do to find this information before you just put yourself out there. So a really common question, like to go to Hondas, for instance, is how do I K-series swap my car, rotary car? What do I need to do to turbocharge my NAFC? Like these sort of questions have no sort of research behind them. They're just kind of people spitballing ideas. And realistically, people that ask these sort of questions are people that never actually follow through with what they're asking. So a lot of times they're ignored. So if you're a new person getting in, try to ignore asking that sort of question. Look up what you want to find before you ask it. Now, I understand that not every question you want to ask is going to be found on Google. That's entirely reasonable. You can ask someone that question, but if you show someone like, hey, I was trying to find this on the internet. I was trying to find what type of turbo would be best for my setup. I've looked at this and this, and I see these. Which one would you recommend? Is a more informed question than asking, hey, I just got my NA car. How do I turbocharge it? You know what I'm saying? So like looking for information before you ask somebody is grateful. I know that I got it every single day when I worked at a performance shop, and it was just downright annoying. And that's like, I'm not trying to push anybody off from learning new things. I'm just saying, look it up before you ask. So that takes me to point number two. And point number two is be patient. Everybody wants to have the fastest thing alive immediately. And it's people like to blame millennial generation. People like to blame people that are 20 years old and younger, but that's not true. Everybody is this way. Everybody's always been this way. No one's patient. No one's been patient. No one wants to take the time to learn. For instance, I've been in cars since I was 16. I'm now 24. It's been 8 years. 8 years of knowledge gathering. And when I started out, I had a spray painted interior. I had a giant subwoofer set up. I drove an NA Eclipse for a while. Like, it was just like, it was awful. It was really awful. And now where I'm now, I have four RX-7s myself. I now actually drive a Civic as a daily. I'm about to pick up a CRV. I'm about to build the Civic to a GSR Turbo. I'm about to do all these things, but like that knowledge didn't come immediately. It came over time. And that goes back to don't ask stupid questions. I research things. I did research and I asked people, I asked experts, I followed people, I followed what they were doing, I observed what they were doing, and now I've applied it to my own thing. So being patient, people see the end result of what people build and then expect to get the same thing within a matter of months or days or weeks, or maybe like a year or two, not realizing that some of these builds that you're seeing on the internet that are really popular take heaps of money, heaps of time, heaps of research, and tons of knowledge, and people don't want to put forth the effort. It's like with anything in life, like people want to become millionaires quick, but no one wants to put in the effort to make those millions. People want to be the best athlete, but no one wants to go and put the extra hours in the batting cages. People want to do this, but they don't want to put in the effort to do that. So if you want to have a built car that's respectable, if you want to have a car that makes you happy, put in the time. Put in the time is all you have to do. Be patient. Nothing is built. Rome isn't built in a week. Blah, blah, blah. Every cliche you've ever heard from every motivational speaker, every cartoon ever, all those things are applicable even in the car scene. Like be patient. That's all you have to do. Be patient. Take your time and you'll be happy with the results. The span of time that it takes you to build something makes the end result that much more gratifying. If you spend 6 years building a car, at that 6 year, I promise you, you will not regret any moments of those 6 years as when after you've gotten there. the end result is nice, but people don't take into consideration the amount of information and everything you learn from simply the journey. Be sure to soak in what you're learning in the journey. And not only that, you learn so much more if you take your time. So number two is be patient. I think that's one of the most important ones. Number three is do it for yourself. Build cars for yourself. Don't build it for Instagram fame. Don't build it for YouTube fame. Don't build it for street cred. Build it for yourself. There are so many people out there that go, I build my car for me. And they'll post on Facebook asking people for their opinions of their car because they clearly didn't build it for them. They want to know other people's opinions. And that's cool if you want to do that, if you want the fame. But you're not going to find any actual happiness unless you're building a car for yourself. If you build it to prove people wrong, if you build it to impress other people, why? Why are you doing that? Build it to impress yourself. Show yourself, expand your knowledge, expand your outlook. That's all you have to do. Like, cars are awesome. They're cool. They're great self-expression. But that's what they are. They're self-expression. If your self-expression is doing what other people think is cool, if your self-expression is following other people's footsteps, that's cool, I guess. But at the end of the day, build the car and know that you're going to be happy yourself. Don't be discouraged when someone says something shit, because there's always going to be haters. Haters are motivators, but like, that's always going to be a thing. People are always going to hate on cars. So if you build it knowing full that that's what you want to build, that's all that matters. Don't give a shit about what other people say about your car. It's that simple. And I know that the last video I made, one video that got a little fire, was the five things that ruin car culture. A lot of people took that personally, but they really shouldn't have, because it's just some dude sitting in his house in a chair talking to you on YouTube about a video about what I think about cars. A lot of people say that person is like, I don't care. You shouldn't care. It's just an opinion. So don't worry about what other people have to say about your car. Whether or not it's like, even though I said eBay's ruining car culture, it doesn't matter. I don't give a shit. Like, just do whatever you want to do. I'm just saying from a business perspective, what's happening. Number four, and this is one that's a little more advanced, just a beginner, but that is don't overpromise and underdeliver. I'm sure we've all seen videos of car enthusiasts being like, just talking about their cars with like fake parts. Like, some dude said his Charger had like a Ferrari exhaust, and like some dude's like, well, my car has three turbos and triple knots. Like, some people do it for fun, but some people do it seriously, and that's an issue. Don't if you don't know what you're talking about, don't speak. One of my simple basic laws that I have in my own mind is, if you don't know, don't speak. It's that simple. There's no shame in not knowing something. There's no shame in saying, hey, I don't know this, will you teach me? There's no shame in that sort of thing. So don't act like you know something if you don't know something. I don't know why that's a hard thing for a lot of people to pick up. A lot of car enthusiasts make that mistake where they say, I know this, but they don't know shit. Don't be that person, because if you are that person, it'll reflect poorly on you forever. So if you don't know something, do not speak. And that comes down to don't overpromise and underdeliver. Don't say your car has something when it doesn't. Don't say you're going to do this when you haven't done that. It's that simple. My last tip, and since it's getting a little long, my last tip is a very simple one, and it kind of applies to all of these. And that is simply listen. And when I say listen, I mean more than just listen, obviously, but pay attention to everything. Pay attention to what other people are doing, sort of, I guess, if that makes sense. Pay attention to the people that you want to emulate. Pay attention to people that are doing things right. Because the more that you watch these people, the more you're going to learn. You watch people like Speed Factor. You watch people like, I don't know. You watch people like Speed Factor. You watch people like Praying to Racing, like Humble Performance. You watch Bullet Humo. You watch Major League. You watch all these car teams. You watch these people do things that are incredible. And the more that you watch them, the more you're going to learn. The more that you're apt to set your goals higher, to aspire to be greater. So listening simply to what people have to say goes a long way. It keeps you from, one, asking stupid questions. It keeps you from thinking that everything is just handed to you, that's gonna be immediate. It lets you be patient. It lets you know that people are doing cars for themselves. They're building them for themselves, so you can build them for yourself. Furthermore, it allows you to, if you listen to people, it lets you understand where you are realistically in your build, what you can realistically do, what people are going to do, where you should set your goals. Listen. Listen applies to not only listening to people audibly, watching videos on YouTube, it also applies to reading people on Facebook, reading forums, reading build threads, learning from people, nitpicking, picking whatever you want to learn, and learning it. It's that simple. And the thing is with cars, as with anything in life, is simply put in the time and you'll learn over time. It's not a foreign concept. A lot of people want to make it more difficult than it is. Cars are not mysterious. Cars are not super difficult. They just take effort. They take time. They take learning. And they take just downright commitment. And that's all I wanted to say. Nothing crazy, hopefully. Hopefully no one's super offended by this video. But to recap, number one, don't ask stupid questions. Two, be patient. Three, do it for yourself. Don't overpromise and underdeliver. And five, always listen. Listen to what the people are saying, no matter who they are. Listen to what they're saying so you can learn. Positive or negative, you're always going to learn something. And that's the end of the video. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe. If you want to see more videos that are preferably rotary related, there's going to be some more on the side over here. But we'll be back in the rotary car video soon. I'm just taking a slight break for a bit, but then we'll be back. So I appreciate you guys for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next one.